By learning the history of Slinger and a town that you live in, you really get to see deeper into what the town offers, and you get to see the impact that has been made on that town.
We've been able to interview over hundreds of people, go on several site visits with various places, the racers, the agriculture, the farmers, the grandparents, just many people in the community. When students come back, they have a really good sense of what people are like in this area and what our place is like. And then we help them take photographs, learn how to document those stories, and then write them down in a way that we think is very beneficial to not only them, but the generations that are older than them. And so it's really great to watch them connect with the community.
My friend and co-worker through the writing project has a bumper sticker that says everything is connected. And that's something that I think is a theme that really embeds itself in the work that we do with the writing project and that we try to bring into the schools as well. You know, making connections in the schools between writing, telling stories, but also into the content area classroom in social studies and in science, that a lot of narration can really help to connect people to ideas, and that understanding where you come from goes beyond just driving down the street and seeing these businesses, but actually getting to know what the history behind those businesses really is all about.
I took interest in Mr. Joe Merton's garage because it wasn't a typical aesthetic like what a garage usually is. And so I decided, well, there's something interesting behind this. And so I began to think about who Joe Merton was as a person and what kind of legacy he's going to leave. And what he's been doing after all these years that's so important to him, rather than keeping a clean garage.
He's somebody that had been working on cars in the Slinger community ever since the Model Ts were around, and he had a few jokes about that, getting it in any color you wanted as long as it was black. And he talked about the legacy of really starting the garage with his dad and working on cars with him, and then all the way up through more modern times. One of the things that Hope really helped to unlock was the legacy that he brought, that this was the place that people would gather.
At first when I saw it, I'm like, oh, you know, a garage, unconventional. But then when I started to learn, see what it was, I was fascinated. I thought, oh my goodness, you know, there's so much more to this. And I thought, it's just such a cool experience, and I want more students my age, older, younger, next coming generations to realize that there's so much more that you can reveal in your writing to others that are just so important to your understanding of the world around you.
In Slinger High School, I took part in a sociology class, and within the class, I took part in the community project, and I researched Forster signs. When I actually got to go out and talk to Corey Forster and really see all of his signage work within the high school, within the community, it really showed me how deeply connected his company is, not only his company, but many others too.
Learning these facts in the class, it was kind of hard to remember some of the stuff, but putting a name and a face to the facts, it was easier to remember the stuff.
I think observation is key. If you don't see it, sometimes it's hard to believe it. And so ultimately, by connecting beyond these walls and then having them do some reflection, they sometimes are able to realize that they are very similar to people that have been doing things for many generations in the Slinger area. When they share that with someone else, especially someone that might be a little bit older, not only are they learning something, the youth, but also those that are a little bit older learning something about the youth.